You know, I didn't expect to make a Persona 5 video this soon, but here we are now. Now that Persona 5 Royal has finally been released in the West and I've had a chance to play it to completion, I can give my really brief thoughts. This is gonna be a bit of an odd video. My usual videos about Atlus games have been deep dives into what the game is and talking about the theming and symbolism. But this time, I want to do something a little different since the game is still pretty new. I'll be giving an overview of the new content and changes that Royal brings to the table, and also injecting my own opinion on these changes to see if it's worth picking up over the original, since that game only goes for like 20 bucks now, which is a total steal. That doesn't mean that this video is going to be a replacement for a big Persona 5 analysis like I did for Persona 3. Trust me, that's still going to happen eventually, but I just wanted to talk about the game while it's still relevant, you get me? There's going to be some minor Royale spoilers in this video, but I won't be going too in-depth about the new school semester since that's obviously the main job picking up this game. I'm going to assume you have at least some knowledge on the original Persona 5 for the sake of skipping past old content and focusing on what this game does different. But in case you need a quick reminder, Persona 5 follows a group of vigilantes called the Phantom Thieves of Heart. They are on a mission to reform society and punish any criminals whose sins have been overlooked, whether that be a teacher who abuses their power to sexually harass and assault students, or even smaller cases such as parents taking advantage of a guilt a teacher felt after her student died in an accident. The way the Phantom Thieves accomplish this task is by using what's known as the Metaverse, a parallel reality that connects to the hearts of society. People with heavily distorted desires have what are known as palaces. Each palace is ruled by a shadow of its human counterpart and is based on the perspective of that ruler. The Phantom Thieves infiltrate these palaces in order to steal the ruler's treasure, which is the source of their distorted desires, in order to get them to confess to their crimes. I know that this sounds pretty confusing right now, but trust me, all this information is explained rather well in the game. And my explanation of this is very simplified because the actual story deals with themes such as how popularity can cloud your vision, letting someone take advantage of you because you owe them your life, and so on. For the most part, I think the game does a pretty good job at handling those messages, but not without some problems. Persona 5 Royal brings a lot of new changes to the base game that I didn't even know I wanted until they were introduced to me. I'll start with some of the bigger changes, that being the altered palace level design and the revamped mechanics. A lot of the palaces stayed intact and features the same gimmicks as they did in the original Persona 5, but have been more streamlined. Let's take the 5th palace for example. One of the gimmicks featured here was having to gather information to find out which shadow was of which rank in order to get to the chief director. This went on for far too long and was pretty confusing. This time around, you only have to figure out who the chief director is instead of going through the unnecessary steps. This greatly improves the pacing of the later palaces, because in the original game, the length of the palaces became really long, especially the 7th palace. This is a change that I definitely welcome. The palaces are inherently more explorative now with the introduction of a new collectible called Will Seeds. There are 3 Will Seeds per palace. Every time you collect a Will Seed, your SP will be restored slightly. Collecting all 3 Will Seeds will grant you with a special item. Some of them are really good, like really fucking good, as in give any character in your party the ability charge or concentrate good, while others are kinda useless in my opinion, such as giving worse versions of skills that you may already have. Accessories have been greatly overhauled. There are still the standard ones that give you stat boosts or resistances, but now there are accessories with skills attached to them. Ever want to give someone like on win skills? Well, now you can. This opens up an entirely new level of customization and playstyles. For me anyway, some party members that I never used before became mainstays in my team. There have been changes to the way the baton pass works as well. Just like in the regular game, when you knock down an enemy with their weakness or a critical hit, you're able to pass your turn onto another party member. Not only have they changed the baton pass so that you don't need to be at a certain confidant rank to unlock that ability, you just start off with being able to baton pass to that member. Now, the baton pass increases attack damage after every pass. This effect stacks with every pass, making it so you can potentially do massive damage if you play your cards right. I like these battle changes a lot, but I think it comes at the expense of throwing the game balance heavily in your favor. I already thought that the original Persona 5 was a pretty comfortable game, all things considered, though it became pretty easy later on, especially if you maxed out the strength confidant. Persona 5 Royal didn't change its design to compensate with the new mechanics. What I mean is, you get so many offensive options and can output so much damage, but the game doesn't have any challenges that test you on those skills. I picked normal for my playthrough and I kinda regret doing so. I ended up changing my difficulty to hard mode near the end of the game when it ended up only costing 6 SP to do Lucifer's Morning Star skill. I'm of the opinion that just because a game is easy, that doesn't mean it's not fun to play. I'd rather play a game that's a bit easy where I can still have fun than playing something that's frustrating and unfair. But I will admit, Persona 5 Royal is probably best enjoyed when playing on hard mode and above. The combat wasn't the only thing changed in Royale. There are some new social events and some overall quality of life changes added. I don't have a whole lot to say about them, but I'll just list off the ones I really like. You can now dash on both the overworld and inside mementos as Car Morgana. This makes just going around areas so much easier. Confidants will now phone you after you rank them up, giving more opportunities to get extra points towards their next rank. When you're in LeBlanc, you can go to the bathroom to check how close you are to leveling up different social stats. This alone is a lifesaver for management. Speaking of which, you can now clean LeBlanc at night to get points towards both Kindness as well as Sojiro's Confidant. There are also crossword puzzles that you can partake in at night. I'm shit at these. Ammo for your guns now replenishes automatically between battles. This alone makes guns actually useful in combat. Mementos has been expanded and now has reasons to explore every floor. Jose here offers a shop with exclusive items that can be purchased with flowers, whether that be SP items or even blank cards for skill card farming. Jose is also able to change the properties of mementos in exchange for stamps that can be found all over the area. You can increase how much XP, money, and items you can earn. Mementos now changes music after every two blocks, and these new tracks are sick as fuck. There is a new alarm system that has been implemented in the Velvet Room. After you defeat enough enemies, the alarm will activate. During these fusion alarms, whenever you fuse a persona or itemize a persona, the result will be better than expected, but at the same time, there is a higher chance of an accident occurring. And this sucks when you're trying to make something really good. If you're trying to perform a group fusion, but don't have the personas on Joker, you can now just buy them straight from the compendium when you decide to perform the fusion. Personas now have a unique trait that can be passed on during fusion. A persona trait is a passive buff that can completely alter the way you build your personas. This can lead to making more creative persona if you're the experimental type. This is one of the more substantial additions. Royale added a brand new location to explore, Kichijoji. In Kichijoji, you can invite your friends to play darts and billiards with you. These activities will give you points towards your confidants, but they also serve a secondary purpose. When you play darts, you're able to rank up your teammates' baton pass to give them added bonuses, such as restoring some HP after each pass. More importantly, you actually get to play this dart through a minigame where it follows the rules of 301. This is unironically one of my favorite additions. But none of these changes compares to the greatest change Royale brings to the table. The nights where Morgana forces you to go to sleep have been greatly reduced. You still can't leave LeBlanc during those nights, but that means you can work on your social stats pretty much every night now. I am not lying when I say that this change alone makes Royale worth it in my eyes. The main draw of Persona 5 Royale is the new story content, that being the new confidants as well as the brand new semester. Since this stuff is still very new, I won't give an in-depth analysis of this new content, but I will give my spoiler-free thoughts. I'm usually not very satisfied with the content Atlus usually adds in remakes and remasters, and at first, I wasn't really digging this new stuff either. Kasumi especially came off as very generic at first. But by the time the third semester came, I was honestly shocked at how much I enjoyed the new content. It has a very slow pace at the start, which was kind of annoying to get through, but I actually think that the new palace and the new villain is some of my favorite parts of the game now. My only real complaint comes with how disconnected the story feels from the rest of the game. The original Persona 5 plot already wraps up by the time the new content is introduced, and this new finale feels like it's trying to replace the previous one, which I personally think that it succeeds at because I'm not a big fan of the original Persona 5's finale. But that's a discussion for another day. The third semester, when compared with the rest of the story, doesn't matter at all. But the standalone story it tells is super high quality and definitely worth checking out if you're a fan of Persona 5. It's really hard to talk about the third semester without mentioning spoilers, but I assure you that it's pretty good stuff. That brings me to my main question of this video, is Persona 5 Royale worth it? I can say with certainty that this is the version of the game to pick up, even if you already own the original Persona 5. The quality of life changes end up making the game flow much better. The new activities and confidants are a welcomed addition, and the third semester is a lot of extra content for you to sink your teeth in. My biggest problem with Royale is that it's a bit too easy, so I would recommend you bump the difficulty if you're already familiar with Persona 5's mechanics. Way to go, Atlus! You finally made a re-release I can fully recommend.